Good afternoon. Today we are going to speak on Nippon India Fixed Horizon Fund XL3 Series 1 Regular Plan. On August 13, 2021, Nippon India Mutual Fund has launched a closed-ended income scheme. Nippon India Fixed Horizon Fund XL3 Series 1. The investment objective of the scheme is to seek to generate returns and growth of capital by investing in the diversified portfolio of central and state government securities and other fixed income debt securities. Maturing on or before the date of maturity of this scheme with the objective of limiting interest rate volatility. However, there can be so assurance or guarantee that the investment objective of the scheme will be achieved. So, it is a fixed maturity plan, as we can see here. And it will mature in 1,755 days. So from the date of allotment. For the purpose of achieving the investment objective, the scheme will invest in a portfolio of debt and money market securities maturing on or before maturity of the scheme. Under normal circumstances, these schemes will invest 90% to 100% of its assets in government securities, state development, loans, SDLs, and debt instruments, whereas up to 10% of its assets can be invested in money market instruments. As mentioned in the scheme information document SID, the fund management team will endeavor to maintain a consistent performance in scheme by maintaining a balance between the safety liquidity and the profitability aspects of the various investments. The fund manager will try to achieve an optimal risk return balance to management of the fixed income portfolio. The investment in debt instruments carry various risks like interest rate risk, liquidity risk, default risk, purchasing power risk, etc. While they cannot be done away with techniques, the fund management team will take an active view of the interest rate movement by keeping a close watch on the various parameters of the Indian economy as well as the development in global markets. Investment views decision will be taken on the basis of the following parameters. These are the prevailing interest rate scenario, quality of the security instrument, including the financial health of the issuer, maturity profile of the instrument, liquidity of the security, growth prospects of the company or industry. Any other factors in the opinion of the fund management team? The fund management proposes to use analytic risk management tools like VIR, convexity, modified duration for effective portfolio management. The NFO opens for subscription on August 13, 2021 and closes on August 17, 2020, as we can see there. So Nippon India Fixed Horizon Fund XL3 Series 1 performance will be benchmarked against RISIL medium term debt index. The fund will be managed by Mr. Amit Tripathi. The new fund offer price is Rs 10 per unit and the minimum application amount for initial purchase is Rs 5,000 and in multiple of Rs 1 thereafter during the NFO period. The scheme offers regular plan and direct plan, having growth options and income distribution come capital withdrawal plan, IDCW, yeah. Then payout options. Then the units of the scheme shall be listed in the BSE Limited. However, the trustee reserves the right to list the units on any other stock exchange. The regulation requires that every closed-end scheme, except equity-linked savings schemes, be mandatory listed on the recognized stock exchange. Investors will not be able to redeem their units during the tenure of the scheme, and there will be a redemption by the fund on the maturity of the scheme. However, the units held in the remittance on the stock exchange, the AMC reserves the right to list the units of the scheme on any other recognized stock exchange and late date after obtaining required approval from respective stock exchange.